Welcome to the Learning Designer. The Learning Designer is a tool that helps you plan your teaching. It does this by asking you to think about the learning experiences you're planning for your learners to help them meet their learning outcomes. When you log into the Learning Designer, you see two options, a browser screen and a designer screen. We're looking at the designer screen. And I'm working on a learning design for access to education and training learners. It's for an activity based around World Book Day. To find out about World Book Day and use that to plan a lesson to teach Year 1 learners. So I've put in some context at the beginning, including a title, topic, description, aims and outcomes, how many learners involved. I can link the learning outcomes to Bloom's taxonomy of learning domains. I can specify the length of learning time I'm designing for, and the tool will automatically calculate how much time I've used as I continue with my design. This helps me check that I'm not planning too much or too little for my learners. I'm going to make sure I click Save regularly all the way through. So the next thing to do is to start building the detail. So I click this button, which will add what we call a TLA, or a set of teaching and learning activities. Well, I need to give my TLA a name, and I'm going to highlight that this will involve individual activities completed online. And I need to decide what kind of learning experiences the students should have. I can choose from 6 learning types: read, watch, listen, collaborate, discuss, investigate, practice, or produce. In this case, I'm going to choose Read, Watch, Listen because I want them to watch the video about World Book Day. So I need to decide how long this might take. I'll say maybe 5 minutes. And how many learners it's going to involve. Well, they're all going to do it individually, so I'll put 1 there. And I need to decide whether or not the teacher needs to be present. This is useful for helping me design my blend of online and face-to-face activities. In this case, the teacher doesn't need to be there while they're watching, so I'm going to click to say no, the teacher is not present. And then I'm going to give a description about the activity and attach a resource, a link to the video on YouTube. I click on the plus sign to add the URL. Now I need to add another learning type because I want the learners to do some research themselves. So this time I'm going to choose investigate. I'm going to add some instructions and link to the sites I want them to look at, as well as a handy resource, Harvard Generator, for helping with the referencing as they take notes. This one will take a bit longer. I'm going to say 30 minutes. So the teacher doesn't need to be present for any of this, so I can ask the learners to do all that before class online, because this is a flip learning design. Then in class, we can concentrate on doing something with what they have learned. So I'm going to add a new set of TLAs and signal that this is for a face-to-face session. In class, I want the learners to work together, first in pairs, then groups of 4, so I'm going to add a discuss activity for them to discuss what they found and a collaborate activity for them to create a lesson plan for Year 1 learners together. I still don't think it's totally necessary for the teacher to be there while they do this, however, so that could give me some more options if I wanted to make this an online task too, but for now, I think the learners would benefit from discussing it face to face. The next set of TLAs will be all about sharing the output of the previous activities, again face to face, but using technology, this time Google Slides. I'm going to choose produce for my learning type because I want the learners to give a presentation to the others, and while they're listening to the presentations, they can make their own notes to develop their lesson plans. Finally, I have an extension activity that involves everyone working together to create a set of learning resources about World Book Day. So I'm going to choose collaborate for that and link to Padlet.com, where I have created a digital wall for this activity. So I finished my design, but I'm going to check a few things. I'm going to look at the total amount of designed learning time. And I seem to have underestimated how much time this lesson will take, so I'm going to adjust that. And I'm going to look at this pie chart that's been building as I've added TLAs to see the proportion of activities that the students are going to experience. And that looks appropriate to me. So now I'm happy with my design and I'm going to click Save again so it will appear in my personal space when I next log on and click Export Design and choose Export to MS Word to download it as a Word file. If I want to share this with other people, then I can click the share icon to get a shortened URL. We use an ethical link shortener so users get a preview screen to check before going directly to the site, but you have the option of getting rid of that if you prefer.